You know when you see a currency exchange rate on the news? Well, you might think that number is the whole story, but it's not, not even close. Today, we're going to pull back the curtain and look at the hidden number, the one that tells you what a currency's real purchasing power is.
Right, so if that daily number isn't the full picture, what is? I mean, what's the measure that cuts through all the noise to tell us what one currency can actually buy compared to another? That's exactly what we're going to get into.
So that rate you see every day, that has a name. It's called the nominal exchange rate. But there's another number, a much more powerful one, that takes something huge into account, something we all feel, inflation.
And that, my friends, brings us to the star of the show today, the real exchange rate. So let's just break down what that actually is.
Okay, so here's the big idea. It's not just about swapping one currency for another, like trading a dollar for a euro. Nope, it's about swapping purchasing power. Think of it this way. It takes that simple exchange rate and then adjusts it based on how much stuff actually costs in two different countries. Basically, it's the number that tells you what you can really buy with your money.
And believe it or not, it all boils down to this one pretty elegant formula. I know, it might look a little scary at first, but trust me, it's super straightforward once we break down what each of those letters means.
All right, let's take a look. So the little e, that's our goal. That's the real exchange rate we're trying to figure out. The big E, that's just the normal exchange rate, the one you see on the news every day. P star, that's just the price level abroad. Think of it as the world price. And P is the price level right here at home. See? Simple as that.
Okay, so theory is one thing, but let's make this real. We're actually going to plug in some real numbers from a past scenario and see how this formula works in action.
Okay, let's rewind to 2010 for this example. Back then, the nominal exchange rate, that's our big E, was 4.65 Israeli shekels for every one US dollar. But here's where it gets interesting. The inflation was totally different in both places. In the US, you had about 2% inflation, so we'll call its price level 1.02. But in Israel, inflation was way higher at 8%, so its price level is 1.08. That difference is key.
All right, time to do the math. Let's plug everything in. We start with our nominal rate, 4.65. We multiply that by the US price level, which was 1.02. Then, we take that whole result and divide it by Israel's price level, 1.08. And what does that give us? Boom, 4.392.
Okay, so let's put these two numbers right next to each other. The number on the news, the nominal rate, was 4.65. But the real rate, the one that actually tells you about purchasing power, was lower, 4.392. That gap, that's what economists call erosion. It's like the true value of the currency got, well, worn away by inflation.
Okay, so a number went down. Big deal, right? Well, actually, yeah, it's a huge deal. This erosion has a massive impact on the real economy, especially for a country's exporters. You know, the businesses trying to sell their stuff to the rest of the world.
And this quote right here just nails the problem. Basically, when that real exchange rate erodes, it gets harder for businesses to make money selling things overseas. Why? Simple. Every dollar they earn abroad just doesn't go as far when they bring it back home to pay for their own costs. Their profits get squeezed.
So, what's the bottom line here? What was the culprit behind this erosion? It all comes back to that gap in inflation. Because prices in Israel were shooting up so much faster than in the US, the real value of every single dollar earned from exports just got smaller and smaller.
All right, so let's just zoom out for a second and put it all together. That nominal exchange rate, think of it as just the headline. It's the real exchange rate that tells the actual story. What's really going on under the surface with a country's inflation and its true buying power on the world stage.
So we want to leave you with this final thought. The real exchange rate isn't just a nerdy formula. It's an incredibly powerful tool for understanding how competitive a country really is. And it forces you to ask a really important question. If your prices are climbing faster than your competitors, are you really getting stronger, or is something else going on? Something to think about.